So the little evening cicada has started up their little song. Beautiful. Dusk. Quiet ending to a great day where, because we've made efforts, right effort, it's borne fruit instead of wasting time. We got down to the work at hand and took go time as serious. This is go time, which means it's time to put in the time instead of just a few minutes. The greatest sign of commitment is what? Time. By putting the time in, that is the signature of commitment. Because time is the one commodity that we don't get back, is it? No, we can't get it back. It's one thing we all have in common, isn't it? 24 hours to a day. So by spending time, that shows a level of commitment. Making right effort, that shows level of commitment. It's go time right now, which means we need to clarify our direction, wherever it may be. We have this great diversion now called the 2012 Olympics, where people will probably let their guard down and lose their momentum. Hopefully not. Because the events and the laws and the direction that the world is going in right now, you can't afford to give up 17 days kind of taking it easy and saying, well, what's on tonight? Let's watch the Olympics. Forget it. There's a time for that, but there's also a time to get down to business. And now is the time to get down to business in the world. And now is the time. So that's what we've done today. And we've made enormous strides in clarification. Almost like historic strides in being able to connect the dots and get the big picture and get oriented in a great way. All because of right effort and right use of time, commitment, committing time, committing effort, and getting the job done. No substitute for that. And that has to continue. We have to continue the momentum. It's momentous times right now. We don't want to get swallowed up by the times. The best antidote to the times is to be hot on the trail of truth, which is what we are right now. I can tell you that. I realize, wow, there really is a way to freedom, to safety. There really is a way. The crystallization of the attitudes that traditionally have been called the blood of Christ, the attitudes of Christ, those attitudes, the crystallization of those, really will opens the door as it is to being passed over by the entire scenario of loss and finding oneself, everything, all loss having passed over and vanished. What are you left with? Paradise. No loss. That's literally what will happen. And all it was lacking is this crystallization of these attitudes of defenselessness. Resist not evil, turn the other cheek. The deep, deep understanding, the crystallizing of those attitudes, and that's it. You've got your ticket. literally. The world is really something that you need want to have bypass you right now. When the Joker in the deck shows up, that's a bad sign. Very, very bad sign. And the ticket, literally out of this madness, the ticket is, again, the crystallization, the coherence of these attitudes, this clarity, that nothing real can be threatened. Perfect safety is found in perfect defenselessness. Resist not evil. Love your enemies. Give all attempts to accomplish the impossible are equally futile. There's no meaningful outcomes in a dream. No consequential or meaningful outcomes at all in a dream. All outcomes in a dream are equally meaningless. Judge not, lest you be judged. Don't cast any judgment on existence. Because as soon as you do, you will fear yourself being judged, because you will think that there's some part of a dream that is more real than another part, which immediately plunges you into the dream as if it had value, as if it had meaning. So, final judgment, no judgment. All attempts to accomplish the impossible are equally futile. No judgment. The dream of loss has no effect on reality whatsoever. Reality needs no defense. Reality needs no defense. The crystallization of these attitudes, of these clarifications, is your ticket out of this place, because this entire place will bypass you. At a deep now, what does that mean? We'll find out, but it will almost be as if the veil seems parting of the veil, as it were, as existence will seem to thin out, seem to be getting thinner and thinner and thinner. It will seem to be dissolving, kind of fading out like a slow fade. Somehow it will depart like that. Become kind of shadowy, unsubstantial, insubstantial, however you put it. Not substantial. Less and less like shadowy, transparent. Meaningless, flat. This Passover will occur. The world will pass us over. It'll pass us by. It will, more than passing by, it will just flee from us, as it were. Withdraw from us. We don't have to do withdrawal. We don't have to withdraw from anything. We just have to allow this withdrawal of the whole scenario of loss to occur. And we just let it happen. And don't struggle. Don't resist. Don't force it. Just let it happen. It happens automatically. So the crystallization of these beatitudes of defenselessness is our ticket out of this place. It literally, that is the ticket. And the world will pass us by. And we'll find ourselves in beautiful, beautiful places. Beautiful place, the death-free realm. And there may be steps before that where we find ourselves being moved to certain places. I don't know how that's going to work, but I'm pretty eager to find out. This is starting to get very fun now. Real fun. This is real fun. Going through the process of the Passover, the world passing you over, is going to be real fun. And we need to embrace it. And I will. Ready for that. Looking forward to it. What's going to happen? It's hard to imagine a better place than where I'm at right now, but there might be some better places, even more beautiful, serene. and just let the world, you know, leave from you, withdraw from you, as it will. It'll automatically withdraw from you at all levels, the whole scenario, but in a very gentle way. And somehow awareness is something, you know, various experiences could take place in this withdrawal of the world from you. Because in the previous one, video about the Passover, be passed over and be saved. That's all explained why this takes place. So we have something to look forward to. Those who have, who understand and will adopt those attitudes of resist not evil, love your enemy, and the various, what I've spoken about, those various clear seeing, realization that this is the ticket out. We're on a grand trip. We're on a great trip. And we need to see that more and more and more. And I'm gearing for that. I'm aiming for that. And seeing things in a different perspective now. It's kind of like turned a corner. Really have turned a corner. Again, July, I said July would be the turning point. It would be the all-important month. Because we had a choice to make during July. Which way were we going to go? And I said, you know, the Olympics is kind of a indicator of the choice that we are going to make. I decided to pass it by, you know. Not watch it, not participate. I always watch the Olympics, always have, every year, every 4 years. But this year I said, no, this is go time. This is serious time. This is choice time. This is destiny time. This is, you know, ticket time. We need to purchase our ticket. And so that's why, you know, I'm saying, okay, time to get moving now. Because by the time we swing into August, we have to be going for broke in our direction, the direction that we're going to go in. We're going to have to go for it. Okay, August is going for broke. Because what's after August? You start going into the autumn, September, October, November. And that'll be real crunch time, really crunch time. Because after that comes December, end of 2012. And that is the time slated for all sorts of stuff to take place. So really August is go for broke. Go for broke. That is when you make your move. July is when you make your choice. August is when you make your move. That process begins. It's moving time. August is moving time. It's Passover time. The Passover process begins. So I had to ground this clarity here in this world before then, before August, and been able to do it. So now we have a clear picture of what's going on and what we need to do. And how can we crystallize those basic concepts, those basic attitudes? How can we make them, you know, crystallize and strong and steady? That is the what we need to find the answer to. And who knows how things will go? We'll see. But it's a fabulously interesting time now. You should feel that in your life. It's a fabulously interesting time. Opportunity is now here. July is the month of choice, and some of you have already made your choice. And then August is moving time. Go for broke. Gotta go for it. You're going to start to feel the effects of your choice now. We had up through July to make our choice, and now the effects will be felt, because the attack on this world, as it were, the loss, the scenario of loss, will now start to get moving. And in doing so, it will become so active that those who are going to be passed over by this, that Passover will also become very active, very active, very intense. So there'll be a shuffling of the deck will take place. And circumstances could change for the better. You might find yourself in a place that's incredibly beautiful and calm and peaceful and no crime and gentle, and your life may seem to suddenly be taken care of in a miraculous way, and you just say, oh my gosh, it feels like I'm heaven bound. And you are. You're literally heaven bound. Because you chose to side with truth. That truth needs no defense. That reality needs no defense at all. And by abiding in this feeling of defenselessness, automatically attack and loss has to pass you by. Because there's no meat there. Nothing to bite. No meaning. Meaningless. And loss does not take actions that it sees as meaningless. Attack does not take actions that it perceives as meaningless. Empty calories, you know. It won't snack on empty calories. We got no calories for it. Doesn't see us as food. You know, I mean, when wild animals are on the hunt, they're not hunting for rocks. You know, they're not paying any attention to rocks. Because there's no food there for them. They're not paying attention to empty air. They're hunting for, you know, animals that are fleeing them. They see the animals, it's bounding here and there. The tiger, the lion is chasing after the animal that is resisting. They don't pay any attention to the rock or the tree or the air. No calories there. So, defenselessness. There's no calories for loss there. No meaning at all. So simply abiding in this defenselessness, that is your ticket. And automatically, attack will begin to pass you by. Not only that, it will say, get out of here, you know, get away from me. Attack and danger and all that stuff will say, get away from me, get away from me, get as far away from me as you possibly can. Go somewhere else where, you know, where there's no attack. I'll say, okay, sure, no problem. It just happens, it'll happen automatically. So I believe we'll see. Proof in the pudding. The proof will be coming now. Put it to the test. Put it to the test. That is the mantra, I guess, of August now. Put it to the test. What's this, the 20 days, September, April, June, and November. So July has 31. So you have a Sunday, a Monday, and a Tuesday to go. 3 more days, and then we're into August. So we're swinging into August right now. And abide in this feeling of defenselessness, realizing that your perfect safety is there. Perfect safety. And we'll find out how the world rearranges itself because of this. Has to. The world has to. Because as attack springs, you know, it doesn't want anything that is meaningless to it in its way. It only wants to see prey, you know, in its way. And if you're not prey, it doesn't want you in its way. So it says, get out of my way. You got to get out of my way. It automatically. That's fabulous. Just pray that this crystallizes. Call on the great gurus. Call on the inner grace. The great saviors, gurus. Inner grace, God's grace. And ask for a crystallization of this defenselessness. And then we'll find out what happens. Literally. People are engaged in the lost space scenario, either pro or con, either they're prey, predator or prey, one of the two. They literally don't want to be in any place where they're safe, where they need no defense, where they're safe. They want to be on the battleground. So they won't go to those places, those peaceful places. They won't go to them. They literally won't. I've been to various peaceful places, and the amazing thing is that there's nobody there. Really. I know some fabulously peaceful places, my gosh. And you go there, and nobody's there. It's like everyone's been raptured onto the battlegrounds, as it were. And you're the only one that hasn't been raptured because you have no desire. The whole lost space scenario, no reality, nothing, none of reality cannot suffer loss in any form, any way. Needs no defense. It's not vulnerable. So you rest in that knowledge, and you find yourself in an incredibly beautiful, peaceful place. There's nobody there, hardly anyone there. Everybody else is out on the battlefield, girding their loins for battle, and the final showdown, Armageddon. The good, the light versus the dark, good versus the evil, this versus that. They're all getting ready for the big old showdown, the hootenanny of horror. Terrible tantrums all going on all over the place, and they'd want to find a resolution to this mess. Let's find out, who's got the right stuff. Meanwhile, so they can't find that out in a place where they're perfectly safe. How can you find out who's got the best stuff in a place that's perfectly safe and needs no defense? There's no battle there, no conflict, no nothing to determine anything. Just a acknowledgement that reality doesn't need anything to be determined. Truth is true. Reality is untouched by dreams of its destruction, its demise, or even its protection. Doesn't need dreams of protection either. Doesn't need dreams of loss, doesn't need dreams of protection. Neither one touches it. So, only those are there that are opting out of this loss-based scenario, the scenario of loss, struggle, and all that. The rest are where they believe opportunity lies. In these peaceful places, they don't see any opportunity. But if you're wise, you see the opportunity. You see it, this is a springboard to paradise, really, the death-free realms. Beautiful places on this planet are like a springboard to the death-free realms, where you can get a little bit of spring, like a diving board. You bounce up, you bounce higher, and finally the last spring you go really, really high, and instead of going down, go up into the sky and disappear, as it were. So it's a springboard to paradise, the death-free realm. But we will see. We will see. August, moving time. We will see how this plays out. In the meantime, keep working, keep focusing on your choice. If you can hear the explanation in the Passover to be and be saved video. If you can understand that, hopefully you can understand it. I'll keep clarifying it. Perhaps tomorrow, I'll clarify it for you even more in various ways that you can make a choice. Say, okay, this is the way I'm going. Okay, good. That's done. I chose it. And take a big sigh of relief. If you intuitively understand the whole rationale behind these teachings, that turn the other cheek, love your enemy, resist not evil, perfect safety lies in perfect defenselessness, and all this, if you can intuitively feel Yeah, that actually is the answer. Even though you don't have it quite clear conceptually, then just go with it and realize, okay, let's go with it. Let's put it to the test. Let's put it to the test. Because everyone else is going to be making massive efforts of defensiveness. Right? Defending against the storms that are to come here. And there's some very nasty stuff coming. And so they're frantically, defending against it. And the nastiness in seeing this is, aha, this is where I need to strike. Look at all those defenses. This must be where value and loss of value can take place. But if there's no defensiveness, loss can't even see you. Don't even exist. I've said that I've lived my life. Most of the time, it's like I go out in public and around, and people don't even notice me. Like I'm invisible. It's a weird thing. It sometimes I get a little bit irritated. I feel like saying, "What am I, a ghost? I don't even exist. You can't even see me." People will like go in line in front of me or something. I'll just be looking at them, and then finally I'll kind of make my presence known, and they'll kind of start like, "Huh? Oh, I didn't see you," they'd say. That's literally what happens. They're kind of flustered, like, "Oh, I don't even see you." It's now I'm starting to see that it's true. People don't even see me out in public. I don't register. It's a weird thing. And it's been this way for a long time. I couldn't really figure it out, but now I see this part of the Passover process is that the world really can't really see you anymore. It starts passing you by. And those who have attitudes of defensiveness and attack and all that, if you have if you're defenseless, they can't even see you. They don't even register in their psyche. So that's the answer to a very perplexing life that I've experienced of people simply, not even noticing me. So that's an example, really, of how there is a parting of the ways taking place. There will be a parting of the ways. The world will now actively, very actively pass by defenselessness. And not just on the level of interaction in society, but the whole structure of the planet, the entire planet, everything will pass you by. The structure, part of the structure of your body will pass you by. Sickness will pass you by. Maybe fatigue will pass you by. The whole scenario of loss will pass you by. You may feel your body, becoming lighter and lighter and more transparent or something like that. I don't know. But we'll find out in the months to come. We will find out. So this is the best of times. It's the worst of times and the best of times. Because the world is demanding a showdown now. It's showdown time. And so anyone that is defenseless, this showdown doesn't even see it, sees no purpose for it whatsoever, has to pass it by automatically. Has to. So just by, you find yourself, huh? Find yourself making a soft landing in paradise, which welcomes you. Because there's no showdown there at all, there's no loss there at all. So it doesn't overlook you, it sees you perfectly clearly. It says, "Welcome, welcome, welcome." This is absolutely fabulous. This day has been a memorable day, a remarkable day. And suddenly, clarification is snapped into place, as it were. And there may be some more snapping into place. And I would say, for those of you who enjoy this channel, it is going to be really something coming up. A lot of support here. maybe even more support taking place in other ways. I may be moving into that, who knows, but the time is really pregnant with great opportunity. I had a dream recently that was so extraordinary that I just not can even talk about it. But if that really, something like that takes place, you know, wow. We're in for the best ride imaginable. Like, you know, ride to paradise, as it were, literally. Which is kind of what we've all been hoping for, really. I've always had this way to sidestep all this whole scenario. But now it's suddenly, it's not just a way. How to purchase the ticket. And how to get on board. And take the flight. So this is the greatest of times, really. The end of July 2012. Greatest of times. Just that little extra effort today. That little burst of effort, you know. Was all that it took. And thanks to all the viewers that encouraged me to keep going. Keep working at this. It's been a collaborative effort, really. I could never have done it without the viewers here. The subscribers, the viewers, the encouragers, the commenters, everybody who says, hey, you know, I like your videos, you know, keep up the good work. You know what? That made the difference, really. It's very true. Because a lot of times I said, you know, this is just too tough, too dangerous, really. And then I'd get someone would say, hey, love the videos, really helpful, keep up the good work. And then I'd say, hey, okay. Let me keep trying. Let me keep trying here. It hasn't been easy because theoretically, you know, I'm sticking my neck out very badly. Sort of number one on the list of those who should be ill-treated, as it were, ruffling a lot of feathers potentially. But it hasn't turned out that way, really. Because the purpose was to get to the truth and the ticket to paradise. And that was the purpose, not to be mean-spirited in any way. So really, I had very little trouble from the world. Some. I had some that were pretty serious in magnitude. And I just kept on trucking because of the encouragement of the viewers, really. So a little encouragement goes a long way. It's always good to give some people encouragement. It helps. Big time. So now that the encouragement, you know, is coming back to you, as I'm, you know, doing my part here in being able to connect the dots. I'm able to do that because that's my specialty. That's what I've, you know, spent my whole life working on. Is to be here at this time, to be able to connect the dots and, you know, punch our tickets, get the tickets. Here's the ticket booth. Here's the ticket booth, folks. Come on over to the ticket booth and get your ticket to paradise, literally. Because that's what happens when the world passes you over, which it must do when you adopt a position of defenselessness. It must and will pass you over. And the result of that is you will find yourself in the loss-free domain, which we call paradise. You'll literally find yourself there. Not from the result of any death or dying or anything like that. It'll be a conscious. It'll be a conscious thing. You'll be conscious. You'll make a conscious. You will find yourself there consciously. It'll be quite a trip. Great trip. See what we can do. Maybe I'll work on a video tonight. Inside. I'm outside right now still. It's evening time now. There's so much more depth to being outside like this. It's fantastic. It's like addressing the world instead of being in a little cubicle. You know, there's no walls out here. Very gentle. right now, time here, incredibly calm and still and gentle. Man, I tell you, this atmosphere, this place, the climate, everything, incredible. It's cool. It's really cool. It's just like perfect. Slight coolness. And we're in the middle, end of July. Beautiful, sunny day. Just warm, not hot at all, very mild. And now this beautiful, serene, gentle coolness. The soft cricket or whatever it is in the background there. Doing its little drone. All we need is a bansuri flute now to accompany this little drone of the cricket. So we're headed towards great times. I'm supremely optimistic now. Because I've seen the dynamic. It's like, wow. There really is a dynamic there. Wow. And so we'll put it to the test. We'll put it to the test. And we need to move rapidly. We need to do this quickly. So, stay tuned here. I keep churning out these videos like hotcakes. And never know what tomorrow will bring, but so far so good. So hopefully you're subscribed. I find subscriptions to be extremely helpful. I have a whole list of channels I subscribe to, and whenever one of them puts a video up, I just click on subscriptions, and there it is. I see it, and it saves a lot of time. I wish my YouTube channels would produce more videos, because a lot of them don't produce them anymore. A lot of them. There's only a few that are actually still putting out videos. Amazing. Maybe like 1 in 10. Not many people that keep with it. There's a few channels that continuing to put out videos. So we've gone through a tough period here. Really, it's knocked a lot of people out. But we've been able to keep going and even increase our pace, which is a great sign. Thanks to all the viewers. I mean, if I weren't getting views or comments or nothing, I probably would have just stopped. Say, what's the use? What's the use? But I've gotten some encouragement. My wife told me, hey, don't worry about it. Just keep doing it. Keep doing what you're doing. Don't pay any attention whether there's any views or anything or not. Doesn't matter. Just keep at it. And I said, oh, thank you. Great advice. Just keep going for it. Keep going for it. And now we're in the driver's seat. We are literally in the driver's seat at this point in time. That's a sigh of relief. That's a sigh of relief. We're in the driver's seat. At last. At last, we're in the driver's seat. Can I get a hallelujah from the congregation? Amen. Great. Very great. And from this point on, you know, it's a matter of driving, moving time, going for it. So we will do that. Very great. Let's end this video. Can we make it less than an hour? We did. That's really interesting. That's amazing. Okay. All right. Very great. That's it for this video.